Cashing on Creativity podcast. I'm your host, Bruce Elridge. If you're listening to this on the podcast, we're at episode number 86, and today we are going to show you how to unlock your inner dominatrix. Oh, you think it's that kind of show, but don't worry. Don't worry. It's pretty good, but it's not what you're thinking. Get that out of your mind. Anyway, listen, we are going to talk with Dana Pharant today, and Dana is a former dominatrix. She's now a speaker, consultant, business coach, and we're going to talk to her about what it took to unleash that and how it turned her career around and the things she's doing now and all that kind of stuff. So stay tuned. We're going to be right back with Dana Pharant. So stay tuned.
Oh, good. So you're doing a ton of stuff. Now, you and I are both parts of CAPS, which is the Canadian Association of Professional Speakers. Mm-hmm. And when we met, you were, I have to say this on air, that you are one of the most welcoming people on the, and you're now on the board and all of that. But I listened to your podcast. When we connected, I listened to your podcast. And when I listened to it, it was like you gave me freedom. This is the one thing that you talk about, the inner dominatrix. And for me, it was that inner, I've always struggled with the same thing. I'm a cartoonist, consultant. Are you the cartoonist or are you the consultant? Because those are not necessarily go together. And when I listened to your episode, I thought, wow, if she can talk about dominatrix and be in the corporate world, I could talk about cartooning in the corporate world. So tell us how your career started. You were a massage therapist and all this. So tell us how you kind of got started in this world.
Okay. So I'll take you on a brief journey, kind of hit the highlights. So, yeah. Cause it's a little bit long. So 92, I started as a massage therapist and then along the way, about 99, I opened up a supply outlet and extra clinics. So I started running massage clinics. I had a supply store for all the goodies for other people.
Right.
And then opened up a second clinic. And in that just kept growing. Now, along the way, in the time of 2006 to 2012, I just kind of insert this in, that's when I got involved in the kink world, the
right.
BDSM, which is the dominatrix piece.
Right.
And I had such incredible experiences in there that I really wanted to pick up the whips and facilitate people through that modality, which was a very healing modality. Little nugget, I know.
Yeah. That's so awesome. So as a speaker, how's your, you've got a very strong brand, actually. I'm going to ask you how your branding's going, but it's very strong. I'm not asking because I think you need to improve it. I'm just, one of these things where the corporate market may not understand exactly what you're trying to, so how have you kind of overcome that?
Yeah. And you know, it's a definite challenge. I mean, to come up and front and center and say, okay, my branding is the inner dominatrix.
Right.
First of all, the word dominatrix for most people conjures up image of sex.
Yeah.
And that's a misnomer. You
right.
know, a dominatrix, it's not a prostitute with a whip.
Right.
That's not the point.
Yeah.
It's actually much closer in alignment with coaching and facilitating, or healing. But I'd say for the corporate world, what I've been sticking to is professions that are a little bit of a hybrid between straight up corporate, like employee, and the entrepreneur. So lawyers, life insurance, real estate, those kinds of things where they recognize that they really need to own their power in order to be able to do the job that they're doing.
Right, right. What inspired that? Like, I mean, to come from that world and... I mean, you've had a bit of a reading on your website. You've got a bit of a troubled background. We won't get into that here. But what made you say that's the one thing that's going to propel me into this other world of speaking and all of that? Like, you know, most people would try to hide that. You've actually gone the opposite way and exposed that. And so what was that? Was there an aha moment where you said, oh, that's just, or is it go, that's going to get some people to read this blog post? Like, what? You know, how did we work that? Right?
It's a great question. It's both. So I have to back up and give a little bit of backstory in that this massage supply outlet that I had built it up to a 7-figure business. And then in 2012, I hit a bankruptcy. And it was the transition of the bankruptcy and turning the business around, restructuring it, that I realized what was missing for me was that I was not bringing that power that I had in my personal life into the leadership of my business. And the minute that I did, as soon as I brought all of that into my business, I was able to turn it around and make it profitable, as well as a number of other factors. Like, I really saw a lot of things go more smoothly for me. And I realized this is what is the missing piece, particularly for women.
Yep.
And that's what created the desire for me to move into it. Now, there was like a 3-year period before I was really willing to own it, because like you said, it's challenging, you know, to be coming out. And then it meant that, you know, it was like, there was going to be all kinds of questions from my husband and how does that fit for him? And all of these things. But along that journey, every time I tried to not have the dominatrix theme, I just felt like I was not fully in. I didn't feel like fully engaged. I was just like everybody else.
Yeah.
And so I would step into the inner dominatrix and it was like, that's me. That's my platform. That's who I am. I need to just dive in and figure out the rest.
Yeah. And that's a strong thing to do, because, you know, a 7-figure business, most of us would have just said, well, I've done that. I know how to do that. It's easy to get back into that world and just build it. You know, if you're focusing on money, that's the easier way to get to 7 figures. You've already done it. You know how to do it and what it takes. So just to completely switch and now go into a new direction with something that's super personal is a great strength, and commend you for doing that, because most of us would go the other way between our.
Yeah. And I, and, you know, honestly, Bruce, I did for a little bit. Like it took me four and a half years to turn it around to the place where I could sell it. Right. And in that time, there were lots of times where I was like, oh, that's too hard. This was my, you know, my transition to owning the dominatrix for me. I'm like, oh, this is too hard. I'll just focus on getting more sales in the supply world. But then like, there was just no heart in it for me. And if you've ever done sales, you know that it's so like an authentic salesperson cannot sell something they don't believe in.
Right.
So once my heart went out of doing the massage supplies, I couldn't sell it. I couldn't do, you know, keep ramping it up. I had to make the transition. I had to go into something that I loved.
So let me ask you this. Do you still have a partner? I think you have are you married?
Yes, I'm married.
Okay.
Yes.
So how's this go for him? Because I know if he's sitting at the bar and he says, well, my wife's the inner dominatrix, I already know, you know, he's getting all the pats and all that stuff. So how does that go? How does he handle that part of you being, because you're really, you're on Facebook, you're on social media, you're everywhere, you know, and it's not something that he can hide behind, you know, sooner or later he's going to come out. He may, you know, as being the partner. So how does he handle that? I'm just curious to know how that works.
He's an amazing man. He is extremely supportive. So I always try to make a point of letting people know that he is not my submissive, far from it. He is my equal partner. I adore him for that. And his big thing, and what he brings me to tears whenever I think about this, is that he just wants to see me love what I'm doing, being really happy, being me. And so he's like, you go for it. You go and do what you need to do. He was more of a cheerleader for the inner dominatrix than I was in the beginning, because he saw the fit. He's like, go, like, do it, go for it. So
yeah, that's awesome. I'm just curious, because a lot of times the spouses or the partners get kind of caught in this. You know, my wife's the same way. She handles all the admin for our business, but she's like the cartoonist friend, and then she's the speaker's wife, and you know, she gets caught in these roles. And sometimes she's now getting better at how to handle that or what I do, but for a long time she didn't even know what I do, because I do so many things. She goes, I don't know, he's speaking and he's doing this, he's doing that. So yeah. What are you, you're that was your turning point. So now what are you hoping to bring that to, let's just say, an individual? We'll get into your clients in a minute, but an individual person that's looking for consulting or looking to bring that power, how are you helping them with that inner dominatrix stand to bring out their power?
So the best example I can give you is, you know, when you're running your business, whether you are a consultant, doing sales for another company, you have a full out business, there's always a component where you have to sell who you are.
Right.
And in order to sell who you are effectively, then you have to believe in yourself.